Welcome to Draw My Story. In today's episode, we're gonna draw the life of SpongeBob SquarePants. That's right, our very own animated comedy character, which has made I don't know how many kids' childhood lives amazing. So let's get started. SpongeBob is the brainchild of Steven Hillenburg, a marine biology instructor and animator. He created it for Nickelodeon, a television network. The show first got aired in May 1st, 1999, releasing its first pilot episode. SpongeBob was originally going to be named SpongeBoy and the series called SpongeBoy Ahoy. But later on, both of these were changed as the names were already trademarked. It's the fifth longest running American animated series and the highest rated series to air on Nickelodeon. As of late 2017, the media franchise has generated $13 billion in merchandising revenue for Nickelodeon. Wow, that's a lot of money. Let's look into SpongeBob's life now. SpongeBob lives in the Pacific Ocean, in a small town called Bikini Bottom. The citizens of the city are mostly multicolored fish who live in buildings made from ship funnels, and for transportation they use boatmobiles, which is a combination of a car and a boat. SpongeBob SquarePants is an energetic and optimistic sea sponge. Its physical appearance is like a rectangular kitchen sponge. He lives in a submerged pineapple house with his pet snail, Gary, who meows like a cat. SpongeBob has a childlike enthusiasm for life. He works as a chef at the Krusty Krab, the most popular restaurant in Bikini Bottom, and cooks their most famous burger, the Krabby Patty. His greatest goal in life is to obtain a license to drive a boatmobile. His favorite pastimes include catching jellyfish and blowing soap bubbles. Two houses away from SpongeBob lives his best friend, Patrick Star, a dim-witted yet friendly pink starfish who lives under a rock. Despite his mental setbacks, Patrick sees himself as intelligent. SpongeBob's next-door neighbor and co-worker at the Krusty Krab, Squidward Tentacles, is an arrogant, ill-tempered octopus who lives in an Easter Island moai. He hates his job as a cashier, but enjoys playing the clarinet and painting self-portraits. He doesn't like living between SpongeBob and Patrick because of their childish nature. Another SpongeBob's friend is Sandy Cheeks, a thrill-seeking and athletic squirrel from Texas, who lives in an air-filled diving suit to breathe underwater. She lives in an oak tree and trapped in a clear glass dome, locked by an airtight, hand-turned seal. She's a scientist and also expert in karate. The owner of the Krusty Krab is a miserly red crab named Mr. Krabs, who talks like a sailor and runs his restaurant as if it were a pirate ship. He is a single parent with one teenage daughter, a sperm whale named Pearl. Pearl doesn't want to continue the family business, and she rather likes spending her time listening to pop music or working at the local shopping mall. Despite SpongeBob SquarePants, the show being aimed at kids, SpongeBob's character is like most adults. He has a dead-end job working for a greedy boss, and he has an annoying neighbor and coworker who despises him. Yet, he's one of the most optimistic characters in pop culture. SpongeBob adores his job, thinks the world of his boss and coworker, and never stops smiling. The magic of the show is that it's very much relatable. Maybe you're an adult who's seen the cruelty of the world and is sick of it. Or maybe you're a kid who genuinely loves things like SpongeBob. There's always something you can relate to. SpongeBob SquarePants has won a variety of awards too, including 6 Annie Awards, 8 Golden Reel Awards, 4 Emmy Awards, 16 Kids' Choice Awards, and 2 BAFTA Children's Awards. Even in 2011, a newly described series of fungus, SpongeBobiforma SquarePantsy, was also named after the cartoon's title character. The show is to laugh at its sharp, witty jokes and to marvel at how its animation is so consistently charming and funny. SpongeBob's appeal is broad, ageless, simple, and smart. And it's hardly matched by any other cartoons. No wonder the show's lasted 20 years and is still going strong. And that was today's episode, guys, about our beloved cartoon, SpongeBob. Comment and let me know how did you like it. And subscribe to my channel, guys, if you want to see more Draw My Story videos like this one. Till then,